The forefront of modern technology is a new technique in genome editing known as CRISPR. CRISPR has revolutionized the way scientists are able to manipulate genes within an organism. Previously, gene editing tools were expensive and laborsome, resulting in slow progression in the genome editing field. But what exactly is CRISPR and where does it come from? CRISPR stands for Clustered Regularly Interspaced Short Palindromic Repeats and was originally found to be a part of the immune system of bacteria and archaea. It works to protect against viral and plasmid attacks by storing small sections of DNA from past infections and embedding them into the CRISPR locus within its own genome. When DNA is transcribed, it becomes a strand of RNA, which is then broken down into smaller pieces called short crRNA. At this point, these pieces are considered template RNA strands, which can then bind to an endonuclease called CRISPR-associated, or Cas9, with another RNA molecule called transactivating crRNA, or tracrRNA, to become the CRISPR-Cas9 complex. The complex uses the template strand as a guide to look for matching sequences of DNA within the cell. As some pieces of guide RNA came directly from viral DNA from past infections, when Cas9 finds a DNA match, the CRISPR-Cas9 complex recognizes the DNA sequence and causes it to unwind. Once this occurs, it cleaves the DNA a few base pairs upstream from a protospacer adjacent motif, referred to as the PAM, generating a precise break in each strand. This then disables the viral DNA and protects the organism from its attacks. But why is a form of bacterial immunity a part of the forefront of genome editing? The key to modifying the genome using CRISPR lies in alternating the template strand, making it possible to manipulate the CRISPR-Cas9 complex to cleave site-specific DNA in other organisms. This technique is so revolutionary that in 2020, Jennifer Doudna and Emmanuelle Charpentier won the Nobel Prize in Chemistry for their work in establishing the CRISPR method. In a paper called A Programmable Dual-RNA-Guided DNA Endonuclease in Adaptive Bacterial Immunity, this method is described by replacing the template strand from a CRISPR-Cas9 complex with a genetically engineered single-stranded RNA sequence to match the gene of interest. Once the complex has entered the cell, it will search for DNA matching the engineered template. After the gene sequence is found, Cas9 will unwind the DNA and cleave the site-specific location. The DNA will attempt to re-establish its double strands using its own repair mechanism. However, the process is prone to error. Scientists can establish the function of a gene by examining changes in gene expression due to mutations that arise from the repair process. CRISPR-Cas9 can be used to target many genes at once, which can be essential for studying complex genetic diseases which rely on many genes acting together. The ability to analyse multiple genes at once was not possible with earlier technology, making this advancement a huge step forward. An added benefit of the CRISPR-Cas9 technique is that scientists can be more specific than just cutting DNA and allowing mutations to arise. They can now insert another piece of DNA that carries a desired sequence for a specific gene modification along with the CRISPR complex. Once the DNA finds the cut ends, through recombination, the new sequence of DNA is incorporated into the genome, thus making specific gene modification possible. So what are the possibilities with this new technology? The ability to cut and modify the genome opens doors to the possibility of creating disease-resistant crops, producing livestock with enhanced genetic traits, and the ability to one day cure monogenetic as well as complex diseases. With these breakthroughs, the global burden of disease could be significantly reduced, while the potential for global food security could be enhanced. There are already groundbreaking clinical trials taking place on humans. As of December 2020, two people have been cured of sickle cell anemia from the use of CRISPR technology. Their once life-threatening genetic mutation has now been corrected via genome editing. The successful changes in their genome sequence can be seen in their blood and bone marrow, resulting in the elimination of long-term complications, such as vaso-occlusive episodes and the need for blood transfusions. With all that is going on in the world with the COVID-19 pandemic, a faster, ultra-sensitive, easy-to-read test was needed to assist in the containment and tracing of the virus. Using CRISPR technology, a new test has been trialed using an easy readout and sensitive enhanced strip that can quickly detect results of a COVID-19 infection. If this test becomes widely available, it could help to reduce the need for extended lockdowns and travel restrictions. The evidence of these trials and many others are showing positive results that CRISPR-Cas9 will help scientists everywhere edit the future of the world, one genome at a time.